गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर फिफ्थ चैप्टर फूड सेफ्टी। फूड सेफ्टी, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस स्टडी ए चार्ट। इट इज अ फूड और सोर्स न्यूट्रिएंट्स ऑब्टेन्ड एंड फंक्शन इन बॉडी। इन दैट the first food or source is jowar, rice and wheat. The nutrients obtained is carbohydrates. Function in body is providing of energy. It provides energy. The second food or source is beans and pulses. Nutrients obtained is proteins. Function in body is growth and development of body, repairing wear and tear of the body. Growth and development of body and repairing wear and tear of the body. The third food or source is oil, ghee, etc. The nutrients obtained is fats. These food obtain fats and function in body is provides energy. The fourth food or source is fruits and vegetables. Nutrients obtained is vitamins and minerals. Function in body is gives immunity and resistance and helps in all life process. This is about the chart. For the proper growth of the body, all constituents of food, namely carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, minerals, fiber and water, all are essential. Carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, minerals, fiber and water. If these food materials are infested by insects or spoiled in any way, then such food is not safe for eating. That is why it is necessary to educate ourselves in terms of food safety. Now look at the picture of different events in our surroundings. In picture A, we can see mice or rats spoiling the grains. In picture B, we can see selling of uncovered and unhygienic food. In picture B, we can see the selling of fruits and vegetables in an unhygienic place. In picture D, we can see food grains are not properly stored. All these activities result into change in color, order, texture, quality and taste in food content. Change in color, order, texture, quality and taste in food content. This is called food spoilage. Food spoilage. Now we discuss about factors responsible for food spoilage. Factors responsible for food spoilage. In that, first factor is natural causes. Natural causes. In natural causes, the foodstuff may spoil due to natural causes. All foodstuffs have their own shelf life. Fruits or their skin turn black and may give out a foul or bad odor. The skin turn black and may give out a foul or bad odor. This is about natural causes. The second factor is man-made causes. Man-made causes. When there is wrong handling, overcooking or improper storage, like storing in damp place, or problems during transportation, all result into food spoilage. Wrong handling, overcooking, improper storage, that is storing in damp place, and problems during transportation. These all are called man-made causes. Man-made causes for food spoilage. The third one is properties of foodstuff. Properties of foodstuff. There are some intrinsic factors. Intrinsic factors within the food materials which result into food spoilage. For example, milk and meat, etc. Milk and meat may be acidic or alkaline and they get spoiled easily and very early. They get spoiled early. The fourth one is chemical reactions. Chemical reaction. Some foodstuff undergo chemical reactions on contact with the metals and are spoiled. Some foodstuff undergo chemical reaction on contact with the metal and are spoiled. This is about chemical reaction for food spoilage. The fifth one is microorganisms and insects. Microorganisms and insects. Sometimes foodstuffs may be spoiled due to contamination by microorganisms or insects from the surrounding air, water or soil. Foodstuff spoiled due to contamination by microorganisms or insects from the surrounding air, water or soil is called food spoilage by microorganisms and insects. These are the five different factors responsible for food spoilage. Now we go to importance of saving the food from spoilage. Importance of saving the food from spoilage. With the help of science and technology, India is producing ample foodstuffs such as cereals, fruits, vegetables, fish, as well as milk and milk products. However, many people in our country and all over the world, there is a problem of starvation and hunger. Problem of starvation and hunger. Many do not get even one meal a day. Many of them do not get even one meal a day. Hence, it is our duty to prevent wastage of food wherever it takes place. It is our duty to prevent wastage of food wherever it takes place. There are two types of wastage of food. Two types. The first one is quantitative wastage of food. Quantitative wastage of food. In this quantitative wastage of food, the first reason is using wrong methods of farming. Using wrong methods of farming, that is hand sowing of seeds, inadequate threshing, improper storage, wrong methods of distribution of food. I'll repeat. Wrong method of farming. Which are they? Hand sowing of seeds, inadequate threshing, improper storage, wrong method of distribution of food. This is the one reason of quantitative wastage of food. The second one is feast and banquets. Feast and banquets, resulting into lots of quantitative loss. Improper traditions like offering the excessive food. Improper traditions like offering the excessive food. That is, besides, much food is wasted as a result of custom of offering and serving too much food to guests at traditional feast or banquets. Traditional feast or banquets. These are the two important reasons for the quantitative wastage of food. The second one is qualitative wastage of food. Qualitative wastage of food. Here, the first reason is using wrong methods of food preservation. Using wrong methods of food preservation. That is, excessive use of food preservatives. Excessive use of food preservative result into quality of the food will be reduced. That is called qualitative wastage. The second is washing the vegetables. Washing the vegetables after cutting them. After cutting them. And overcooking the food. Overcooking the food. And third reason is miscalculation of the time required to transport food from producer to consumers. Miscalculation of the time required to transport food from producer to consumers and mishandling of perishable fruits like grapes and mangoes. These are the different activities results into qualitative wastage of food. We will continue the remaining points in our next video. Thank you.